Hello and welcome. In this session, we will be solving problems of projection of solids using a software that is Solid Edge V19. So, we call it as a drafting. So, launch the software, then go for File, New. So many options are available in the V19 version of the software. So, we let us go for DFT. DFT meant for drafting. So, click on OK. So, what we are getting on the screen is the by default a sheet, so that we can see what the sheet size. So, go to File, Sheet Setup. Okay. So, the background sheet is A2, as well as the sheet, what is working sheet, that is also A2 size. So, I will give a shortcut method to adjust everything. So, just change the background to A4 sheet. Okay, because all our problems in the curriculum can be solved on a A4 sheet in the 1:1 scale. So, that's why you go for the background A4 sheet. Automatically, the size of the sheet changes to A4. Then click on Save Defaults. The purpose of clicking on Save Defaults is whenever we add new sheets, so automatically the new sheet size will be of A4 background and A4 size sheet. That's why we are changing the defaults, which was set by the software manufacturer, okay, to the required one for us, that is A4 wide. Then click on OK. Now we can see it is completely changed. We can go and click on fit option to fit the screen, and this background is visible. This background we can edit using, go to view background. Okay, when you click on view background, you can see the background and click on the A4 sheet, again say fit. So there are various backgrounds, so click on A4 sheet because we have selected the A4 background. Now we can select and delete this, or we can edit this, whatever we wanted to do, we can do this. Okay, so because we are viewing on background sheet. Okay, so if we do not want this background sheet, what we can do is go to File, Sheet Setup again, we can go to right click on sheet 1 and go to sheet setup, and in the background option just deselect the show background option and click on OK. Now that background will be completely removed, and this is the A4 size working sheet. Okay, so you have to be very careful, don't work on any backgrounds, please work on the sheet 1. Okay, you can switch off this background viewing also. Suppose this tick mark is not there, then the background will not be visible. You can see there is no backgrounds here. Okay, only sheet 1. Now suppose if I insert a new sheet, so the new sheet will have a background, but the new sheet size will be A4 because we have clicked on save defaults. Okay, the defaults have been changed. So let me delete this right now. We shall see that later on. Now we shall solve a problem on solids. So I'll type the question here. Using, you can change the new fonts, and font size also can be modified, and make a rectangle so that the text what you type will be within that particular rectangle, fit inside the rectangle. So the problem is on a pentagonal pyramid of 25 mm sides and axis 50 mm rests on HP on one of its edges of the base such that the apex is 40 mm above HP, and the edge on which it rests is inclined at 45 degree to VP. Draw the projections. Okay, so to solve this particular problem on pentagonal pyramid, so let us start with the XY line. So take line command, and immediately you can check the color, it will be by default black, and by default it will be a continuous line, but also by default the thickness will be 0.5, which we are supposed to change to 0.25. Okay, because XY line is generally drawn with a thickness 0.25. So draw a perfectly horizontal line. When you draw this horizontal line, now you can see we are not getting any symbol over there, and as the line is perfectly horizontal, we can get a symbol. Okay, so horizontal symbol, horizontal line. So that means the line is perfectly horizontal. So draw a perfectly horizontal line. Okay, Then click on text command and click here, say type X, type Y, type VP and type HP. Okay, if the text is not properly positioned, you can click on the select tool and drag this particular text wherever it is required to be placed. Okay, now let me draw the top view for a pentagonal pyramid. So the top view first we have to go for is pentagon, and it is resting on one of its edges of the base. Okay, so edge must be in the right hand side. Okay, so I go for line, and the thickness of the view, top view, is always 0.4 mm. Okay, so change the thickness to 0.4 mm, enter 0.4 mm value and press the enter button from the keyboard so that the value is accepted. Now you can see the line width or the thickness of the line is 0.4 mm. Okay, now I will start the line somewhere here. I'll tell you why. I'll start a line here. Okay, I started a line here. The length of the side is 25 mm, and I will enter this length value as 25. Okay, and press the enter button. It will shift to angle. Okay, the line I require is perfectly perpendicular one. So I enter a value 90, or I can just move the cursor in such a way that I get the perpendicular symbol over there. Then press the left button of the mouse. Okay, now the second line is required. Okay, so the second line angle, you shall remember that. So it will be like the exterior angle of a pentagon is always 72 degree and the initial angle is 90. So angle for the second edge will be, angle for the second edge will be 90 plus 72. Okay, so 90 plus 72 is the angle required for the second edge. Okay, and so on. Now I will doing it very quickly. 25 enter, 90 plus 72 plus 72, that is 144. Then again I enter 25 length, 90 is the initial angle, plus 72 plus 72 plus 72 is 216, or I can type this way also, 72 star 3. Okay, because the fourth edge, enter, the last edge could be connected to the first point. This is how I can get the pentagon. Okay, now the top view has to be completed. For that, what we need to do is again go to line command, okay, and draw one perpendicular bisector. So this midpoint symbol, what you are weaving on the screen is because of tools IntelliSketch relationships midpoint option is on, that is why. So you can switch off some unnecessary relationships over here, parallel, tangent, etc. is right now not required. The important relationship are endpoint, midpoint, point on element, intersection, perpendicular and horizontal vertical. Okay, so one you have drawn, try to draw another perpendicular bisector, maybe from this endpoint to this midpoint, or it could be from this endpoint to this midpoint. Okay, once you draw two perpendicular bisectors, you have got the axis point. Now what you do is go for trim and trim this and this part. Okay, these two parts you trim. I'll tell you why. Then from the midpoint or the center point, not the midpoint, center point, draw lines to the remaining corner from which the perpendicular bisectors are not drawn. So this is the actual top view. Okay, so this point is O. I'll reduce the font size, 4. It is O bracket O1, which we discussed in the sketching how we name this. So this could be A, B, C, D and E. Again you can go to select tool and just move the text wherever it has to be placed properly. So near the corner you need to place. Okay, so this could be placed this way. So this completes the top view. So once you complete the top view, okay, once you complete the top view, go for line, and the projection line thickness should be 0.05. okay, very thin lines, and draw the projection lines. So draw projection lines from A, B, perpendicular to the XY line, and point on element, means point on element and perpendicular, two symbols you are going to see there. Okay, so it means the line is exactly till the XY line and perfectly vertical or perpendicular to the XY line. Okay, that is very important. The line must be perfectly vertical and exactly till that. So after that, project O and O1 also. because this point is very important, and from this point we are going to draw the axis. Right now you continue with that line, okay, for a length the height of the axis is 50 mm, enter 50 and see that it is perfectly perpendicular, okay, perfectly perpendicular, 90 degree, enter 90 degree, okay. Now this line is a axis line, so axis line type is here this one, and the thickness could be 0.15, okay. This is another way we can draw any line, a line with the any properties, and once the line is drawn you click on the line and you can change the properties as we require, okay. This is another way, okay. Now continue, go for a 0.4 mm thickness, now change the thickness to 0.4 and complete the front view, okay. So from here till here till here and again back to this, and also this point. Why I have connected like this? Because this is my apex O dash, this point is A dash, so connected O dash to A dash. Then the base points are C dash bracket D dash, and here B dash bracket E dash, E dash, and this point is O1 dash. So I can move, I'll zoom this further so that I can place it properly. This point O1 dash and C dash D dash, okay. Fine. Now I'll go for dimensioning. For a better clarity, I can zoom further. Okay, so two dimensions are very important. One is 50 mm, the axis height, and 25 mm, which is the size of the base side. Okay, so what I have done here, drawn a pentagon with 0.4 mm thickness, then drawn two perpendicular bisectors, okay, any two, so that I get the center point. Then I trim off the non-required or unrequired part of the lines. Then once I get center, I can connect it to every corner. This because OA, OB, OC, OD, OE, these five edges are representing the slant edges in the top view. Okay, so in the front view, it represents O dash, A dash, O dash, B dash, which is visible. A, B, C are visible to the observer. That is why O dash, A dash, O dash, B dash, and O dash, C dash are visible. D and E are behind the observer. For this particular front view, observer will be here. So A, B, C is like visible to the observer. D is in the backside. So O dash, E dash, and O dash, D dash are exactly behind O dash, C dash, and O dash, E dash. Okay. So this completes the first step. For the second step, the condition given is, the apex is 40 mm above HP, okay. So 40 mm above HP. So what I have to do is, I draw a line here. Simply I draw a horizontal line. You can see the horizontal symbol over there. Draw a horizontal line, okay, and go for distance between command. It's here. Pick the XY line and pick the line which you are just drawn, okay. Forget about the thickness and all, okay. It's saying that there's a gap of, or the distance between the two lines is 41.55. what we need is 40 mm. Edit the dimension to 40, okay. Automatically it will come here, okay. Let it be. This line could be a thin one, 0.05. I can change it anytime, okay. Now select the entire front view. Now select the entire front view. This is window selection, okay. So I've selected the entire front view, then go for move command always. So first you select the entire, why I'll tell you, select the entire front view which is supposed to be moved, then go for the move command and move from a end point to any point on the XY line. Keep it very close, keep it very close, okay. Okay, one mistake happened. What is that? Is when you move it, when you move, take the move command, this copy option must be on, otherwise the original will move, okay. So copy button you keep on, move from a point on the XY line or a end point of the particular front view, that is C dash, and move it on the XY line, that is point on element, not anywhere else, okay. It should be exactly on the XY line, that is very important. So move it on the XY line, keep it very close, because when you are rotating it will automatically shift off. So press here so that it is copied. Now when you press the right button of the mouse, the front view is already selected. The front is already selected. Why? Because the view was selected before taking the command. Okay, that's why even after the move command, the view is like being selected. Now go to rotate command, because we need to rotate now. Okay, rotate command. C dash, D dash, end point is the rotation center. You can see here, click for the center of rotation. Okay, rotate, center point will be this, and from where to you have to rotate from O dash to this line, okay, to this line, point on element to this line, okay. But again there is a copy option. If you keep copy option on, then what happens is the original will retain there and again the rotated will be overlapping with that. So that should not happen. So the original itself has to be rotated. So switch off this copy option now when you rotate, and rotate in such a way that it exactly touches, you can zoom here, it exactly touches point on element here, okay, point on element on the 40 mm line. But what happens is there will be a gap, there will be a gap here, it exactly doesn't coincide with the 40 mm line. So whatever we have done is like incorrect, okay. So what we do again, we have to do it. So purposely I shown you how the error does happens there. So again I'll go for move. You can deselect by pressing shift button and click on the dimension, because it was selected, got selected, I just deselected that. Now go to move command, move it to the right, okay, point on element, okay, move it on the XY line, and then go, don't go to rotate command, go for arc by center point, C dash is the center of arc, O dash is the radius, draw an arc this way, okay, draw an arc first, draw an arc. And if suppose this 40 mm line is not intersecting that, you can go to extend to next, you can extend this. If it is already intersecting, no issues, okay. Now what I'll do is I will rotate this. Now I will rotate, I have to select the entire front view. If the dimension is got selected, you can press the shift button and click on that, okay. Now I will go for rotate, C dash, A dash as the center, O dash as the rotation point, that is the from point, okay. Now 2 point is this end point, or suppose this line is extended, you will get a intersection point here, okay. So earlier I had selected point on element and it was giving an error, that's why I have drawn a arc first, or now I am getting an end point here. Otherwise if the line is extended, I will get a intersection, so that will exactly move it to that particular position. Okay, now apex is exactly 40 mm. You zoom further and you can check it is perfectly 40 mm above the HP. Now we can delete this arc. This arc is not required. Now I will go for a line with the 0.05 thickness, and I will try to obtain the top view. To obtain the top view, in the second step, I suppose to draw horizontal lines from all the 5 points of the first top view. Okay, so A, B, then I'll go for C, end point, and perfectly horizontal line must be drawn from end point of the top view and perfectly horizontal. Okay, no errors are admissible here. Yes, now A dash, A is here, so draw exactly till A horizontal, point on element and vertical, both the symbols are very important. Then go to B dash and E dash. So first you get E, because this is E horizontal. So click up to here. Then go to B. So B horizontal is here, because so are drawn from B dash, E dash. Go for C dash, E dash. D is here and C is here. Okay. Finally go for O dash. Okay. Finally. And you can see this line is short. So you can go for extend and click this. Similarly, we have another command called trim. We can trim the unnecessary line. So this is E is up to here, okay, and this is on D is up to here. I can trim this, so I can trim this part also. So this way I can get all the points. So I shall name this. And also one more thing is, this text has come below the XY line. What I can do is delete the text and press hold the control button and just drag this particular text to the next view, so that you can place the text. And similarly we can do the same thing with other text also. Press hold the control button and just drag the text which you already written in the previous view and place it on there. So the text should not be inclined, the text should not cross the XY line, that is very important. So all the text I have deleted and press hold the control button and just copied the text from the previous view. Now here I have, here also I can do the same thing. So A is here, I know A is this point, click here, then again click on B, press hold the control button, click once so that the previous selection is cancelled. Then just select the point which you wanted to move, E, and O and O1 I have to write now. This is O and O1 is here. Any O1 is not so important right now. So go to line command, take 0.4 mm thickness and then connect the boundary first as we discussed in the sketching sessions. So draw the boundary first. So boundary for this problem is O to E, A, B and back to O. And when you are weaving from top, okay, O dash A dash is visible, okay, nothing else, only O dash A dash is visible, observer will be here. So connect O to A as a visible line. So what is not visible here? So that is the base, this is not visible, okay, because it covered by the lateral surface of the solid, okay. So base is covered by the lateral surface, you cannot see. So change the like line type, thickness will remain same, 0.4 mm, join a line from E to D, okay, then D to C and C to B, and also D to O and O to C, because OC and OD are here exactly below the solid, you cannot see. Now one continuous line is overlapping here, so that continuous line could be trimmed, okay, using trim option, okay, this way it could be trimmed so that it will be very clear. And also axis is there, but we are not able to represent this axis because this visible edge is overlapping the axis. So first preference is always given for the visible edge. So this completes the top view, okay. So when the pentagonal pyramid resting on HP with an edge and it is inclined in such a way that its apex is 40 mm above the horizontal plane, then these are the second step. Now third step, conditions are given as the edge on which it rests is inclined 45 degree to VP. Okay, this is a condition given. Now which is that edge resting on HP is C dash D dash, resting edge is C dash D dash, that means this is the edge C dash D dash or CD. We compare the length. So given inclination is true here, how I understand edge on which it rests is inclined 45 degree, so it is the actual inclination, okay. And if you observe here, the actual length of the side was 25 mm. Even in this view also, it remains 25 because it is projected horizontally. The length is not changed and the given inclination is also true. Length is also true. So what we do is we simply copy this view, go for move with the copy option on, move from any point to any point, randomly you just move it, okay. And presently the angle made by this view, sorry, this line, this edge is 90 degree. We are supposed to make it 45 degree. So just go to rotate command. Take any point as the center, no matter, any point as the first rotation point, no matter, rotate for the perfect angle, rotation angle 45 degree, because it is already making 90. If you rotate by 45, okay, it will make 45. There is no condition that apex is closer to VP or base is nearer to the observer, such conditions are not given in the question. So I assume that base is nearer to the observer, okay, or apex is near to the vertical plane, okay, this way I will rotate. Now I can check the inclination, let's go to angle between the edge, the resting edge and the XY line, that is inclination to VP is perfectly 45 degree, okay. So this is how I rotated the top view, this top view, such a way that edge is making 45 degree to VP. Now go for the projections, change the thickness to 0.05. and change the line type to continuous and go for ABCD first. So draw perfectly horizontal line for A dash, B dash, E dash, okay, O dash we'll see later, go for O dash. So three lines you draw first, because if there are more number of lines, more confusion. So go for A vertical from the exact endpoint A, draw a vertical line till A dash horizontal, okay, this will give us A. Then from B, this is B dash, draw exactly till there, point on element and vertical. Then C, C is on XY line, C dash is on XY line. So C will come here, then D is also on the XY line, point on element and perfectly vertical. Then last one is E, E dash is here, this is E, and finally go for O. O will be on this line, point on element and vertical. I can trim extra lines here this way. I am deleting all extra lines. Then my next task is to name all the points. This is O dash. So this point is A dash. Then this was B dash. This is C dash, D dash and E dash. Then go to select tool, drag the text and place it properly wherever we want. You can reposition the text after you write by just dragging. Okay, fine. Now go to line command, take the thickness to 0.4 and draw the boundary. Now what do you mean by boundary here? So always start the boundary in pyramid from the apex. Okay, from the apex, if you join O dash E dash, because it is a lateral slant edge, we can draw it, but then A dash remains outside the boundary, so I cannot draw this way. So I have to go for O dash E dash first, then A dash to E dash, then E dash to D dash. This is easy to understand, that is on the boundary, then C dash, then O dash. So this is the boundary. Then to the observer, what is visible? To the observer, the base is visible because AB is very near, so I can directly go for A dash B dash as a visible line, and also B dash BC is very near to the observer, so I can go for BC B dash C dash. Or in other words, the base is very nearer to the observer, it is very near to the observer, closer to observer, so it must be visible. Now OB, you can see OB line is nearer to the observer, so click on O dash B dash. So these are only the visible lines. I repeat again, so boundary is always visible and the edges which are nearer to the observer are visible. So edges near the observer where AB, BC and OB. Okay, so these three are visible. Now how many edges are remaining? They are not visible or invisible. So that is, one is E dash, O dash and O dash, D dash. O dash to D dash. O dash to D dash. Now the last line which is remaining is the axis line. So I'm changing the thickness to 0.05 to project this. Okay, O1 is here. So O1 is here on this line. Okay, I can use this tracking also so that I can save the time. Okay, so the line type was hidden there. I can, after drawing the line, I can change it anyway. Okay, so now I go for line. Change the line type to center with the 0.15 thickness. Draw a line between this endpoint to this endpoint which represents the axis. So I can click on select tool and drag on O1 dash here. So this completes the drafting of a pentagonal pyramid which is resting on HP with one of the edge. That is why we have taken edge condition here, edge in the right hand side. The dimension are 25 and 50. And apex is 40 mm above HP, that's why it rotated this way. I told you the arc is compulsory to be drawn, otherwise O dash you cannot locate on 40 mm line very accurately. That's why the arc to be drawn, and later you can delete the arc. So this is the top view obtained after rotating this way, and the condition given is the resting edge is 45 degree to VP. The edge remains same in length, that's why I'm going for the true inclination here, and after projecting horizontally and vertically I get the final front view. So this completes the drafting of this particular problem on pentagonal pyramid.